Woo-jun apologizes for mistakenly saying that he got married in 2009 when he really got married in 2004. Taiwanese boy band Fahrenheit has been on the news lately for a couple reasons. Formed in 2005, it's a group that brings a lot of nostalgia for many of us growing up. Comprised of four members, Jiro Wang, Calvin Chen, Woo-jun, and Aaron Yen, everyone went solo soon after Woo-jun left the group in 2011. By now, it's no longer a secret that Woo-jun was a father and a husband even when he was still in Fahrenheit. Given the rumors that surrounded him for many years, Woo-jun finally made an announcement in 2013. However, his marriage stirred up controversy again this year when the public realized how early he actually got married. He and his non-showbiz wife, Lin Li-in, are participants of the new Chinese reality show Before Wedding. A scene where they revealed their marriage license shows that they got married on February 4, 2004. Fahrenheit made their debut in 2005, which means that Woo-jun was already married before he even debuted as an idol. Some of his longtime fans felt deceived because when he finally came clean about his civil status, he said that he got married in 2009. An ugly rumor also cropped up online claiming that the reason why Woo-jun and his wife have the same birthdays as their daughter and son was because he forced his wife to have a C-section early and that it resulted in labor complications. Woo-jun's studio released a statement to deny the rumors. Woo-jun also took to social media to stress that he believed that the most important and best decision he has made in his life was to marry his wife and have kids with her, and to be with her as they accompany their kids Nene and Max. He and his wife really forgot their wedding date because they never once celebrated their anniversary. In any case, the couple seem excited to appear on a show together. Woo-jun's non-showbiz wife is rarely seen by the public, and the show marks her first appearance compared to previous ones where she would always wear a mask. When asked about why she has changed her mind and decided to reveal her face, she said that she's older now and her thoughts about it are now different. She's appeared with Woo-jun on shows like Where Are We Going, Dad? And The Most Beautiful Time. Aaron Yen reveals that he's not friends with the other members of Fahrenheit. Years ago, Aaron Yen had already said that Fahrenheit members aren't friends. Appearing as a guest on the show Hua Hua Wan Wu, hosted by Dee Su and Karen Tai, Aaron was asked similar questions, which he faced head-on. Dee asked, "Are you still in contact with the other Fahrenheit members?" To which Aaron responded, "No." When she pressed and asked if it was because he doesn't like them, he said, "Fahrenheit members are not really someone I hang out with, and they aren't really friends. There's no need to fake the relationship, and I personally don't want to fake it too. There's nothing negative about it. We really just aren't friends, and we don't contact each other normally. To pretend that we're friends for everyone to see, how can I keep such a lie, right?" When Dee asked who he wasn't friends with, Aaron responded, "Just a group. Teammates, I feel like to be friends, the relationship has to be on another level. Besides, we really don't interact much." Kevin Tai followed it up with a question of whether it ever got to a point that there were feelings of hate. Aaron admitted that at the height of their career, there were such times as competition was tough. He further explains it by saying, "When, for example, our fans would fight, although you would expect a group's fans to be in good terms with each other, they're really not. It would get to a point where it's too messy, and I'm the type who would try to stop them. But there are others who don't." In the history of Fahrenheit, There were always rumors about bad blood between Aaron Yen and Jiro Wang. Given what Aaron said, Calvin Chen seems to have written a post in response. He recently took to Instagram to say, "At times, whether big or small matters, laugh it off. No big deal. It is not a problem. Good health is most important. Wish you well." The Instagram post earned comments of support from Wu Zun and Jiro Wang. Seems that the other three members of Fahrenheit still hang out with their recent reunion just this January, making the rounds online. Wu Zun had shared the photos from their meetup and even tagged Aaron Yen, who wasn't present, as he said that they'd never forget the times that they fought for their dreams together. In other news, Calvin Chen and new wife Joanne Tseng are as sweet as ever. Ever since the surprise reveal that they're married, the two have been more open about the relationship. Joanne even shared photos of her recent outing in Taiwan amidst lovely cherry blossoms. When the two suddenly took to social media to announce that they were married back in January, the news came as a shock to many who didn't even know that they were dating. Through her agency, Joanne revealed that she and Calvin have been together for around 10 years. Yang Zi and Chris Wu to resume filming for The Golden Hairpin, and her protective gear draws a crowd. Back in January, China released a notice to suspend the shooting of film and television dramas to control the spread of the coronavirus epidemic. As new cases of infection slow in the country, more and more productions are starting to resume filming. On March 9, Yang Zi was spotted at the Ningbo Airport, presumably to resume filming for The Golden Hairpin in Xiangshan. Her outfit drew attention because in addition to her casual wear, she had on a mask, a visor, gloves, a raincoat, and a cap. It may seem over the top, but it definitely feels like a battle-ready outfit to protect her from any virus. On March 10th, her co-star Chris Wu was also spotted at Ningbo Airport. Since he flew in from Canada, he needs to pass inspection and be isolated for 14 days at a designated hotel before he can resume work. With the coronavirus affecting different parts of the world, it's really important to take care of yourself. Wash your hands regularly and stay safe.